this way just to show it. There's slimes on the top of the ceiling, but we can just sprint past them. I think they only drop down. It can be difficult to dodge them, but only if you run this way. So, since they've already fallen, it's fine. Hello, friend. I just wanted to quickly showcase this path, because we never went down it. Although there's an item, right here, with a trap lane for us down here. And I fell for it completely. I forgot that you can't dodge roll in this room. And now it's going to attack us, but we have a soul of the Nameless Soldier, so that's pretty much a net positive as far as I'm concerned. And now we are through this door. And if this doesn't look familiar to you, this turn right here will. This is where the big butcher dropped down on us before, and this is where we saved the pyromancy NPC. So yeah, I just wanted to showcase that little bit of the level that we missed prior to defeating Gaping Dragon. Who, if you recall, dropped the Blighttown key. We can just really easily wade through these slimes. And I'm gonna sit at the bonfire just to heal myself up again. The run to the door isn't very precarious, but still would help to have full health. That's not a good sign, starting off that way. If I wanted to abuse the privilege of the master key, thank you, Pillar, this would be the point where I would do it. But like I said, I want to go through this area the way I originally did, and I don't want to skip or miss too much for the video, or for the playthrough. So this locked door from before, right next to Domhnall, is where we will use our Blighttown key. And as soon as you step in, the lighting just forcibly changes to be this muddy, gross mess. There's a huge hole in the ground. We're gonna cut around it, circumnavigate the hole, and then see the message that says Darkspawn ahead. Very, very true. Slide down here. Okay. Slide down here as well. I'm gonna try to be as careful as possible. I would not be very surprised if we encountered a death down here. Yeah, I've always thought that the backstab hitbox for these enemies was a little weird. Oh, and I almost just walked off the edge right there. I think he still has a very small amount of HP. Nothing an R1 from our Uchi can't fix. I gotta say, this area, more than any other, is probably the most the best benefit that the PC version has over the console version. The frame rate on the console version of this area is just atrocious. That was close. And this wouldn't be the worst of it, this area. When we got a little bit further, that's when it would be awful. And I'm not saying that we won't experience some frame rate drops, because Dark Souls is not the most optimized PC port, but it's a lot better than on consoles. And these big guys' clubs also poison you. For some reason, I remember that attack of theirs going a lot further than that. And he dropped a dung pie for us. Thank you. Very sweet. You have to be very careful with these enemies. Not these ones specifically, but usually when you find these enemies in groups, they're there to distract you from a ranged enemy of a similar type. That's going to shoot poison darts. There he is over there. Luckily, our backstab safety will make it so it can't hit us, but this area may also be our first exposure to the toxic status. And I'm really hoping that it won't be, because it's just horrible. Yeah, these enemies. Thankfully, they don't have very much HP, so once you do get to them, they're easy enough to dispatch. I don't normally head down here, but let's take a peek at what that item is over there. Stabs are definitely not as effective as I was hoping they would be on these enemies. It looked like he was wanting me to backstab there, but quick enough not to do the animation. Okay, so I'm really nervous about this. Okay, Soul of a Proud Knight, I think. I'm not sure, actually. I was going to say, I think the trap here might be that there's... that the ranged enemy that we killed before climbing down here would be able to shoot us there, but that doesn't really make much sense, because... I can't imagine a lot of players wouldn't just kill it before climbing down. Alright, further we go, and the... Well, this looks... Oh, well, let's wait until we kill this. This bridge looks very, very safe. Let's find out. That's so silly. It moves like it's from a cartoon or something. But it definitely throws you off at first, but it's not an unfair amount of movement. You don't even really have to slow walk across them in order to make it. Can we touch this bloodstain? I want to see. Oh, there they go. I figured it'd be something as simple as that. Be wary of sniper, okay. The Blight Town is a very hostile zone, to say the least. You have to deal with a lot of darkness and I thought an armor set would be over here. That's okay, we can hopefully make it to this one, okay. The shadow armor set. Let's go ahead and equip that. I spent a long time not even knowing that this existed, because I never saw anybody use it in PvP or in videos or anything like that. Hopefully we can medium roll. Let's take a look at it. Black cloth garb worn by spooks from an eastern land, designed so as not to hinder their unique form of martial arts. While it sacrifices defense for the sake of greater mobility, it does offer resistance to bleeding and poison, among other things, perhaps due to the nature of espionage. So, you trade defense for general defense for a higher defense to bleeding and poison with this armor set. And it looks pretty neat, and we can still light roll. Although, can we equip the whole set? Although I'm sad to get rid of the, yeah, we can, that's good. I was sad to get rid of the sack, but we used it, and that's all that matters, as long as we used it for a time. Okay, now how the heck do I get to where I need to go from here? Here. We're attracting the ire what's this then? Soul of a Proud Knight. If I can actually, if I can make that jump, I think we're good. Yeah. More dogs. Except they're tiny and red this time instead of regularly shaded and bigger. Here's the bonfire. I'm pretty sure I already went over this, but every time I do go to Blighttown, I go the fast way that skips this entire area, and I will probably show that off. But, so, the only reason I bring that up is that I kind of want to do some exploring this video just to make sure that I don't miss anything cool that I may have forgotten about. Oh, that's not very nice. Fine, I'll climb up to the top and just wait for him to do the same. Hello. The R2 really doesn't seem to give that much better damage. At the trade-off of speed, that is, of the R1. Okay, please don't let anything happen. Okay. Blooming purple moss clump. It's just so... this entire area is just so labyrinthine. And this bridge of all things does the cartoony sway. With slight adjustments, you can pretty much just keep going straight and you'll probably be fine. In case you were wondering why the dogs were now had a red texture, it's because they can breathe fire, naturally. Breathe a lot of fire. So much fun going through this area. Not the most fun, not as much fun as some of the other areas, but it still poses a unique challenge. And there's a very persistent, actually let's take a look down here, there's a very persistent sense of dread and precariousness. So yeah, our goal is to keep descending. I think we might have to go all the way. Oh, is there no way up from here? Something that is also really neat to note, and it would probably be better to point it out when I have an example in front of me, but it can be kind of hard to figure out where ladders are in this area because everything is made out of decrepit planks of wood, and ladders in this game just so happen to be made out of decrepit planks of wood. But the top of every ladder that you can climb has a torch at the top of it, which you'll see when we climb this one. I'm not sure if every ladder has a torch at the bottom, like the one right there, but there's definitely a torch at the top. Just to make it a little easier to see, and that's a concession that you wouldn't necessarily expect Dark Souls to make. Alright, now we can start making our way to the actual progress direction. And I did just respawn the enemies by sitting there, even though I'm not sure I took very much damage or used the Nestus. But that's okay. Shucks. And right underneath it. That's not good. Doesn't look like can't see him, but you can see where the darts are coming from a little bit. Trace their path to that corner there. And yeah, that is in fact the toxic meter, although our meter is quite large because of the shadow set that we're wearing. Try jumping. I don't really want to try that. Oh no. Strange timing for that to happen. Sorry about that, but once again, my game minimized on me. It wasn't for a Windows update this time, so I might have to look into that, but hopefully it doesn't happen again. It was a very silly death because I was just trying to look in the distance, but we'll go ahead and reverse our hollowing again. This time. Now I really don't know where that third person came from. Maybe climbed up a ladder that I didn't see or some such. I'm wondering if we should go this way because this seems to be the... Oh right, there's that thing. Kind of disgusting. Not kind of, very disgusting. Design though. It kind of looks like a gigantic face hugger with some modifications, of course. Oh, jeez, almost just walked right off the edge. Dare we drop down? Let's go for it. Let's live on the edge a little bit. Take some unknown risks. Message probably would have been better to be placed a little bit earlier than after the point where the ambusher tries to get you, the eagle shield. That's like a tower shield, or at least it's bigger than a conventional shield, a little heavier too. Unfortunately, does not line up with our build. Yeah, that path right there is where I wanted to go. So let's see if we can't find a way there. Oh, looks like we should be able to just drop down. Alright. And the 150 souls that we picked up seems as though an enemy fell. Alright. Okay. I believe the easiest way to deal with that parasite is to go inside, but I wonder... Oh, we did a little bit of damage to it, but it would be obnoxiously... obnoxiously difficult, but more so obnoxiously time-consuming to attack and then dodge away, and then attack and dodge away, so hopefully we'll try to find a way around it instead. And here's another big guy that drops the tongue pie. very high poise. Or so it would seem, because it's very difficult to stagger them. Another big hole in the ground. Actually, this could... Oh no, it's not. I was gonna say this could very well be the same hole as there's a fog door as the path when we first entered Blighttown, but I don't think that's the case, because I think you actually do get to the bottom of the hole. Yeah, we've definitely traveled more to the right, so forget I said anything. Now we can go down this ladder or that ladder. Actually, no. Where's that ladder? That ladder's broken. We couldn't go down that ladder. So let's go down this one. Oh, good old Blighttown never ceases to impress. This message hints at an item down here. And you can see the corpse there. That is a weapon, and it is a whip weapon, which is... And it is, in my opinion, awful. I hate using it. It's fun to do, like a Castlevania Simon Belmont type cosplay build with it, but other than that, not the most fun item to use. I'm sure there might be other items down there, and there's definitely a way out after dropping down, but I'm good. Gorgeous view. Well, I'm sure to some. I heard footsteps. I thought an enemy had followed me, but we're now coming up on the tail end of, well, both the video as well as the worst part of Blighttown. Oh, you can't see it anymore, but you, right in that dirt spot to the right there, you could see the shadow of the big parasite facehugger we were attacking. Much like the red dogs, these flea or bug enemies also breathe fire, but also like them, not too hard to deal with, and they have bigger hitboxes, so... Oh, this must have been the guy who fell to give us those random 150 souls. Now, I don't want to jinx it, but... Oh. And we're getting hit by toxic. From where? I'm not sure. Right there. Okay. Whew. I'm sure I explained what toxic is, but it's just like poison, except it's really, really deadly. We do have a few items. The blooming purple moss clumps, which is the same as a purple moss clump, but has the white lilies on it. That also cures toxic, and I believe we picked up just 3 from a single enemy earlier, so... It's not the end of our character's life if we get it, but it's definitely something I'd like to avoid. And just like that. So let's be fast here and use a blooming purple moss clump. Just like that, easy, but you did get to see how much damage it actually does. The Wanderer set, I mentioned that this is one of my favorite armor sets in the game, and it still is. And in fact, I wouldn't be surprised if I switched to it at some point in this playthrough, but for the rest of Blighttown, at least, I'm gonna be using the Shadow set. I'm not sure if I finished my thought from earlier, but I don't want to jinx it, but this is typically where the FPS gets to be the worst. And we've been able to maintain a constant 30, so happy about that. And that is because, obviously, Dark Souls has a forced FPS cap of 30. And unlocking that cap messes with the physics, especially of jumping and stuff. Which is the main reason I don't like to do it. I think I already might have gone into that as well, but just to reiterate my stance on the matter. Ouch. Alright, we've reached a... great and terrible swamp. Hopefully we can get to dry land before, okay. And it is is a bonfire that we have now lit and can rest at. Thank goodness. And that's fantastic. Oh, and there's another person resting at it too. Alright, let's do endurance 18. After we get our next big influx of souls, I'll probably up vitality and endurance to 20, and then up strength to 20, and then we'll see where we're gonna go from there. Now you would expect a golem head. Liar head, yeah, that's particularly funny because this entire area, Infinite Labyrinth too, you would expect something awful in this really big open, almost arena-like circle, but no, it's just nothing there, no new path, and then a chest with a dragon scale. Let's take a look at the dragon scale and see if it tells us what it's used for. Probably passed it already, went kind of fast there. Oh, I think it might be a, yeah, it's an upgrade item. Reinforced dragon weapons, dragon scale for reinforcing dragon weapons, peeled from an ancient dragon. A dragon is inseparable from its scales, and the transcendent apostles who seek the perpetuity of the ancient dragons have crossed the very end of the earth to seek this invaluable treasure. So if we come across any dragon weapons, that will be our go-to. Any dragon weapons we want to use, at least. Alright, now I'm trying to figure... Basically, once you reach this great swamp, great as in vastness and size, not great as in quality, that's for sure. Once you reach here, you kind of have a choice of going to explore further right to that strange structure with the spikes coming out of it that you can't really see right now, but sort of. Or left to a place that doesn't quite have a monument to see. Our goal to work towards, and we are going to go left in the next video after I defeat this pesky red spirit known as Maneater Mildred. And if you watched my Demon's Souls playthrough, how pretentious of me, if you've played Demon's Souls, this NPC may look familiar to you as an enemy that was in the Valley of Defilement with a very similar weapon and everything and outfit, so it's a pretty neat throwback, even though it's a very I meant to dodge roll. Not this is gonna be a problem. Hopefully not though. Was not expecting dispatching this dark spirit to be so intense. Alright, that's okay, it's gonna be a duel. That's interesting, the dark spirits have the ability to slide also. Well, she tried. It was still a valiant effort, and I'm glad she was willing to come to my duel arena in order to do what she wanted to do. Got a soft humanity and three hard humanity, as well as her butcher knife weapon, which is, as you would assume, a strength weapon, so we won't be using it. But that's okay, it will stay in our luckily infinitely sized inventory as a trophy for our duel. From our duel, there's someone with the pyromancy armor set. Alright, right at the 30-minute mark, thank you so much for watching. Take care, and I will see you soon. Bye.